All right, I'm Tim Bartholomew here with Praiseworthy Cinema, and here we got Garrett Batty, right?
Yeah.
And Adam Abel with Freetown. Now today we just we're going to interview them and ask them a few questions about how they got this all rolling and just a word about the film. So how did you guys get together on this?
So I originally found this story in some on a website, church's website. I found a little write-up about the experience of these six missionaries that fled Liberia during a civil war. I thought, man, that's a compelling story. I wanted to find out more. So we put together a script, and halfway through writing the script with Melissa Larson, I said, I'm going to need a producer to help me do this. And I couldn't think of anybody better than Adam Abel to do that. And so fortunately, he took my call.
Tell us about that, Adam.
Well, first of all, I first became aware of Freetown at the LDS Film Festival in 2014. Obviously, we were there doing a panel about Saints and Soldiers of the Void, and it followed Garrett and Brandon Purdy, the distributor of the Saratov Approach, talking about the successes that Saratov had seen. And at the conclusion of that panel, he had a slide that came up that said Freetown and showed some missionaries walking in Africa, and I was immediately intrigued. I didn't think much more beyond that day about it until I got his phone call and he asked, and we sat down and met about it, and him describing the story of these missionaries caught in the Civil War immediately intrigued me, and definitely I not only wanted to be involved from a producer's standpoint, but I also wanted to be able to, as an audience member, be able to watch this movie in the theater.
Well, that's great. I personally enjoyed the Saratov Approach because I served my mission in Russia, so it was pretty authentic, especially the Ukrainian scenes.
Yeah.
Now, what was different about this film versus filming in two countries? I know you mentioned that you'd never film in two countries again. Do you want to go ahead and tell us about that?
Yeah, that was a fun story with Saratov. We filmed 10 days here in Utah, and then we took the crew to Ukraine. And it was such a headache. We thought, man, this is really hard. And we'll never make a movie in two countries again, and thinking that, oh, let's just film right in Utah next time. And, you know, joke's on us, because we ended up filming an entire film in a country that, in a continent, neither Adam nor I had ever even been to.
Yeah.
But it worked out. So the difference is we're shooting in West Africa, this incredible road trip movie of survival and endurance and faith, and it's very, very fun and energetic, and it's a pretty powerful story to look at.
He remained true to his commitment not to make it in two countries. We made it in one. It was just in a different continent.
That's right. There's not one frame that's filmed outside of West Africa. So, right, I kept my word.
Right. Now, this is a lot different from what you've worked on before, Adam, with Saints and Soldiers. A lot of that was filmed in Utah, and you filmed in Ukraine. And here, what went through your minds as you were gearing up for production in West Africa, especially with the Ebola breakout?
Yeah.
Well, as Garrett and I both have said in other interviews, making an independent film has its challenges no matter what the subject matter is or where it takes place. We certainly amplify the challenges when we remove ourselves from the comforts of our home to a continent that is foreign to us and in a country that neither of us had been to. And so there were certainly unique challenges that came because of that. When we had visited West Africa and Ghana specifically in a pre-production trip to determine the viability of being able to do it versus trying to film it in Vernal, we immediately realized that thankfully it had exactly what we needed for the authenticity of the story, as well as there was a growing film industry in Ghana, because they have a handful of film schools there, and they're a developing country and a developing industry. But there was where the crew that we were able to find may have lacked in experience, they made up for it in their attitudes and passion for the project. It's no different making, you know, the challenges that face you here versus there, except it might be amplified because you've never been there before.
Right.
I think the goal, regardless of the project, whether it's a World War II film or, for me, a kidnapping thriller, is to make a story that is authentic and entertaining to the audience, and to not show any seams. Don't show don't show your budget, or don't show that your lack of resources, or that you've never been to the continent before. And so certainly with the crew that we put together, when Adam and I first landed in Ghana, we immediately felt like this was the right place, and all, it had all the locations and everything that we could hope for. And you can point the camera. Jeremy did a phenomenal job of highlighting. Jeremy Prusso, our director of photography, did a great job of highlighting these landscapes and these people and just the beauty that was there.
Well, how about you go ahead and tell us maybe your favorite part about filming in Ghana, and if you want, just something that was unusual or maybe even strange about filming there.
Certainly this whole process has just been an experience, just a refining experience. And so you think that all of the challenges, you know, I could focus on those and say the challenges of, you know, being in a foreign place, far away from my family for a while, or just the regular challenges of production coming up, those would certainly be difficulties. I think then if you have to say what is the favorite part about it, my favorite part is that it really, really turned out. And now we're in the phase where we're showing this film to people, and the type of response that we're getting shows that it was all worth it.
I think I think that like a favorite part is just the people that we were able to meet and interact with. You know, 9 months ago, neither Garrett or I knew any of these people, and then this process, as he refers to this refining process, we've now become fast friends with them and longtime friends that we'll, you know, maintain relationships with and potentially work with in the future again. But I think in terms of that kind of experience, the movie, I think one of the most memorable moments of production for me in the movie was when we were filming in a chapel, a scene where there was a sacrament meeting and the branch is singing a song. They're singing hymn 240, "Know This, That Every Soul Is Free." The tangible spirit that accompanied that scene because of singing these praises was something that I'll never forget, and it was one that I tell my kids about, and I request our ward choir to sing the song, but yeah, it was just one of those moments, the connecting with the people and the experience of making the film.
Well, thank you for your time. I know we've got to get to the movie screening here, but before we go, I just wanted to ask if you have a message for anyone who's going to come see this film, maybe why they should see it, or just anything, like a last word that you want to say about it.
Sure. Yeah, I think the message in the film speaks clearly and is very well articulated by our actors and by Melissa, the screenwriter. So I'll let them come and see the message of the film. My invitation would be to come out opening weekend to see the film. As an independent filmmaker, or you know, any filmmaker, it's important that initial weekend that you're in theaters, that the audience responds. Because if the audience comes out, then you're likely to stay in theaters for a little bit longer, and that's how the story really gets out there.
And I know that helped you with the Saratov approach.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, everybody came out for Saratov approach. They came out for Meet the Mormons recently. And so we hope, and we're inviting people to do the same thing. Come out opening weekend. We're opening this film all over the country on opening weekend. And so it's a big risk, and we hope that people will embrace it.
Great.
Yeah, I would just say visit our website. Become very familiar with where we're opening it. And if you're in areas, inevitably, every time we open a movie, someone messages us and says, what about bringing it to my city? Well, let us know and we'll do our best. The key is our fans drive where we go in terms of driving us to bring it to where they're at. And we just need people to come out and support the movie.
All right, thank you. Well, this was once again Tim from Praiseworthy Cinema, so hopefully we'll see you in theaters.